Namaskar. Yato hasta tato drishti, yato drishti tato mana. Yato mana tato bhava, yato bhava tato dasa. Where the mind is, where the hand is, the eyes follows. Where the eyes are, the mind follows. Where the mind is, there is feeling. And where there is feeling, there is aesthetic bliss. Art. Art is the expression which is the highest imaginative and emotional susceptibility of human being. Arts and other manifestations regarded collectively makes our culture. And a culture of any civilization is as great as its dreams, and its dreams are dreamt by artists. Arts, an artist sees the real world and then turn that real world into the real poetry, real literature, real dance, real drama, real music. And in India, which is a land of a people who are brave and polite, people with warlike lifestyle, around whom grew the most amazing legends of romance and heroism, a place unequaled by any other place in the world. It is packed with history, art, and culture. History is past, art and culture, yes. In the whole world, India is known for its art and culture. And art and culture, in our very own India, the burden of our true art and culture lies on its women. And of course, why not? Women have equal participation of human development. She is half of the human race. But do you know that in Indian art and culture, women has only 25 to 30% participation. Whether it is literature, fine arts, or performing arts. So, can we say that our Indian art and culture is the true representation of Indian women? Of course not. When I talk about an artist, especially women artists, we are here to discuss a very, very strong and hot topic, women empowerment. So whenever I see a very senior Indian women classical dancer or a practitioner or a guru, most of them are fortunately or unfortunately unmarried. I ask them, why did you get married? So they say, Manisha, you know what? We strongly believe in the institution of marriage, but we never found a life partner in whom they can rely that they'll be flourishing as an artist. They will have the freedom of expression. So they could not. So, my appeal is that we all come forward and we all should give this freedom of expression to each and every woman. Why? Why it is important? Arts are not so important, but I guess arts are as important as women are. Can you see, can you imagine your life without arts? I think in each and every house there will be a painting, there will be a book, there will be some songs. Can you live without them? So arts are equally important. You cannot even imagine your life without arts, as you can't imagine your life without women. So if they both are joined together, I mean, there are some marvelous, marvelous examples we have seen when a woman comes forward as an artist, they create the masterpiece of that era. When we talked about Veerabai poetry, we talked about Arundhati Roy, I talked about Amrita Shergill. Oh my God, wonderful the work they have done. So, and another very, very, very good and interesting point is that women is constructed by nature. Maybe for the sake of women empowerment, maybe every woman does not want to fight. She doesn't want to raise her voice. She doesn't want to scream all the time. She does not know how to snatch. But yes, she knows how to construct. I'm not saying that every woman has to become an artist, but yes, she needs to express her feelings through some medium. And she can create wonders. She can create beautiful family, a lovely home, and of course, the overall society of heaven. It's only in her hand. This is my art view. I'm here to present my Kathak dance. And I'll be presenting, I have tried to compile the elements of Vedic era of Kathak dance, then some Mughal nuances, and then finally, the contemporary era of Kathak dance. Kathak is a classical dance which is always evolving in nature. So I'll try to depict everything. Hope you will be able to see the time and the gender politics of women through my dance. Thank you so much.
Hey, Gracias. Thank you.